student, this is Karthik Trivedi and you are watching a lecture series of engineering graphics and design with me. So in today's video, we're gonna see a basic concept of isometric projection, and also in this video we're gonna see some of the example of isometric projection. So let us start isometric projections. So before I start this, let us give you some brief introduction. So you know that in orthographic projection, what we are going to do in orthographic projection, basically we are having a 3D drawing, or you can say we are having a 3D object with us, and what we will do by using that 3D drawing, we convert the 3D drawing views into the 2D drawing view, like front view, top view and side view. So what you have to do, basically you are having a 1 3D object. So what you will do, you convert that 3D object. By looking this object, you will derive a 2D drawing. That means you will derive front view, top view and side view of that particular object. Now it is in isometric projection, it is just opposite to that. So in isometric projection, you will be having a 2D drawing with you. So what will happen? So in plane of paper or in some example, he will give you the front view, top view and side view of some particular object will be look like this. By using this thing, just develop a 3D object. So what you have to do, so in isometric projection, you will having a 2D drawing, and you have to convert this 2D drawing into 3D drawing. Okay, so first thing, before doing isometric projection, it is very necessary that your all concept regarding orthographic projection must be clear, and you must have a good mastery over orthographic projection. So those who haven't seen my orthographic projection video, first go there and see that. So now let us start isometric projection. So as you can see on your screen, projection on a plane such that mutually perpendicular edges appears at 120 degree to each other. So here he has written that the mutually perpendicular edges appears at 120 degree to each other. So here always remember the appear word. It is not exactly 120 degree, but when you looking this object, it will be look like that mutually perpendicular edges are 120 degree to each other. So you can see that, you can see this object on your screen that it is resting on one of its corner, and when you are going to see the mutually perpendicular edges, it is gonna be look like, or it appears that these mutually perpendicular edges are 120 degree to each other. So now iso means same. So you can say that iso angle between the axis. Okay, so you are having the same angle between x axis, y axis and z axis. So it appears something like that. So as you can see that here it is written that example shown for a cube tilted on its corner. So as you can see it over here. Okay, now next thing, what is the difference between isometric view and isometric projections? So as you can see on your screen, you will having a 2D drawing something like this. He has given you front view and top view and has given the dimension of that view. Now he will tell you draw isometric projection. So when he say draw isometric projection, that means what? So here you can see that, see the second figure where it is written isometric projection. You can see the dimension of that 3D drawing. It is not exactly 40 40, it is multiply by something like root 2 root 3, something like that. Okay, why it is multiply by that? So it is multiply by isometric scale. So when you have to do isometric projection, you don't have to take actual dimension of 2D drawing. So you have to multiply that dimension with some isometric scale. Okay, so when you take dimension by converting them into isometric scale, so that drawing will become isometric projection. So always remember, when you draw isometric projection, you take isometric scale dimension. So always remember that. Now what is like isometric scale, that we will see in next slide, so don't worry about that. But here right now, just remember that in isometric projection, the dimension is not actual dimension, but you multiply actual dimension by some particular value according to isometric scale. So always remember that. Now see the third drawing, which and there it is written isometric view. So you can see that the 3D drawing is having an actual dimension as it is mentioned in 2D drawing. So when you draw a 3D drawing with actual dimension whatever given, then that drawing will be known as isometric view. So this is the main difference between isometric view and isometric projection. So in some time example he will ask you draw isometric view. So and sometime in example he will tell you draw isometric isometric projection. So always give importance to this word. Okay, students sometimes makes this kind of mistake, and that's why they lost their marks. So always remember, there is a difference between isometric view and isometric projection. When he says draw isometric view, that means you have to develop 3D drawing with actual dimension. When he says draw isometric projection, that means you have to develop a 3D drawing by multiplying actual dimension with some digit according to isometric scale. Okay, so this is the basic difference between isometric view versus isometric projections. Now let's see what is isometric scale. Okay, so isometric projection appears smaller than the real object. Why it appears smaller than the real object, that we gonna see on the screen? Because all the isometric line gets equally foreshortened. The proportion by which isometric line get foreshortened in an isometric projection is called isometric scale. Now let us understand what this line is trying to tell us. So now see the screen, see the figure on that. So first, what you have to do, let us take example. Let's say in exam he will give you construct an isometric scale for 5 cm. Again I'm gonna repeat, construct an isometric scale for 5 cm line. So now just see on your screen. So what you have to do, see the figure on your screen. So I'm according to that I'm going to explain you. So first, what you have to do to construct an isometric scale of 5 cm line, what you have to do, first you have to draw one baseline, means one horizontal line. So on your screen you can see the OA, which is baseline. So first draw one horizontal line. Now take 45 degree angle and draw one line which is 45 degree to the baseline. So you can see the OC line which you have drawn 45 degree to baseline. So that is a random length line. Okay, so draw any random length line which is 45 degree to baseline. So that is known as true length. Now on true length, here he has given construct isometric scale for 5 cm line. So what he will do, on true length we will take 5 cm dimension and we divide that 5 cm dimension into 5 parts such that each dimension will represent 1 cm. So you can see that on true length 1 cm, 2 cm, 3, 4 and 5 is written on line OC. So what we have done, because here he has given construct isometric scale for 5 cm of line, so that's why we on the true length we have taken 5 cm dimension and we divide into the 5 part and given the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now this is the true length line. Okay, now to derive a isometric length, what we have to do, now draw an other random line which is 30 degree to baseline. So you can see that OB line which is 30 degree to the baseline. So you have to draw any random line which is 30 degree to the baseline, and that line will known as isometric length. Now what you have to do, now see the true length. Now on line OC, see the true length, see the 5 point over there. From point 5, draw vertical, draw downward direction line. Okay, whenever it intersect OB line, it will be a point 5. Same way, from line OC, see the 4 number point and draw vertically downward line. Whenever it intersect OB line, it will be a 4 point. Same for 3, 2 and 1. So now, what is isometric length? So now, you know that on true length, 0 to 5 means 5 cm. Okay, and now come to the isometric length. On isometric length, now you can see that now 0 to 5 on isometric length means on line OB, on isometric length 0 to 5 is not is equal to 5 cm. Now it is become shortened than the actual. So that's why it is known as isometric length. And how much it is shortened, just give me this value. It is exactly something like this. So isometric length is equal to 0.82 multiplied by true length. So let's say if I will give me the isometric length of 5 cm line. So here you know that true length is equal to 5 cm. So isometric length will be 0.82 multiplied by 5 cm. Okay, so that will be the isometric length, and that same answer you will get over here if you measure 0 to 5 on isometric length. So this is known, this is about isometric scale. So when I say draw isometric projection, that means what? That means you are having a 2D drawing, you are having some dimension over there. So what you have to do, you have to convert all these dimension according to isometric scale. That means you have to multiply all those dimension by 0.82, so it will be converted into isometric length. Okay, so now you will understand what is exactly isometric scale is. Now let us see one example of isometric view. Now what we will do, so here the front view, top view and left hand side view is given over here, okay? So you can see on your screen, so front view, top view and side view is given, left hand side view. So now using this 2D view, you have to develop one 3D model. So how to develop 3D model? So first, draw this kind of line in any isometric view, because here it is tell you that, always remember in example he has given draw isometric view, that means you have to draw everything by actual dimension. If he is written isometric projection, that means you, if it is like that, then you have to convert all these into isometric scale, okay? So all this dimension is going to be multiplied by 0.82, but right here he has said only isometric draw view, that means we have to draw by actual dimension. So now what we have to do, first you have to draw this kind of line. Again I am going to repeat, see the screen, you have to draw this line, something like x-axis and y-axis, which is 30 degree to the baseline, means horizontal line, something like this. So in any isometric example, first you have to do this kind of thing. Now next you have to make one cube. So one cube, but which dimension? So here you can say that front view and top view is given. So from there you can derive the dimension. You can see that 20 20 20, that means 60, okay? And height will be what? 50. Same way you can see the left hand side view, where you can see that a 50 mm length is given and height is 60. So according to that you have to draw one cube from point O, something like this, okay? So you have to make one cube according to the dimension given. Now what you have to do, now you have to draw front view first. So you can see the first, see the 2D drawing of the front view. According to that, draw the front view. So look at the on your screen, something like this. Yes, he has given front view something like this, something like this. According to that, do this, okay? So now this much front view is ready. Now draw left hand side, your top view, whatever convenient to you. So here first we will gonna do left hand side view. So see the left hand side view, see the 2D drawing which is given in your example. According to that, draw it. So let's do something like this, let's draw something like this, okay? So according to left hand side view which is given, according to that you have to draw it, okay? Now let's draw top view. So it is going to be something like this. So according to 2D drawing given, we have to draw exactly something like this, okay? So we are going to draw according to 2D dimension. Now see, now extend the edges something like this, okay? And now connect all the edges something like this. And now see the front view, top view and left hand side view of this particular 3D object which we have developed. It is exactly going to be look like 2D drawing. So this is how you can draw isometric view, or you can say isometric drawing of particular 2D drawing given. So what you have to do here in this case, you have to just practice the practice again and again, and then you will become a master at isometric projection or at isometric view. So I hope you will like this video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.